What you're about to watch is a cinematic scene partially created by elements from two packs called Cyberpunk and Cinetitle. You can find them both from the links in the description with the applied discounts for you. As you've already guessed, today we're talking about making compelling sci-fi cinematic scenes like the one you watched inside After Effects. Obviously, the first step is to have a cinematic footage. Whether you film them or buy them as a stock footage, it'll be a solid ground for your scene to build upon it. After that, the movie magic happens in post and how you edit the footage. In this particular scene, we want to add some sci-fi futuristic HUD to our astronauts' helmets. Then close the scene by a cinematic title to give it the sense of a movie trailer. Okay, first things first, we need to track the footage to get some attachable points. So hit track camera and go grab a coffee. Now we have the points we want. I'll select a bunch of them, right click and select create solid and camera. Alright, cut the solid to the duration of the camera and drag it under. Now we have our tracking, but the angles aren't matched with the camera angle, so I'll change them all back to zero. Done. Then I change the position of it according to the helmet. Now we need the new comp to hold all the HUD elements we want to use. Let's call it holder. Next, we want the shape layer to use as the background. BG, okay, and add a grid from the effects panel. Now I play with the corner parameters to make them square and replace the solid with the holder by holding Alt and drag. Then reposition the grid to fit the helmet. Since the helmet glass is curved, we should add Bezier warp effect to curve out our layer and adjust the angles. It should be fully matched with the angle of the glass to look natural. You can see that the grid is helping us to understand it better. Okay, it's perfectly matched. Now to match them even more, I'll add the vignette effect to darken the edges and bring down the opacity to 10. Let's see how it is. Not bad. I think it'd be cool if we could see the rest of the last shot as a reflection on the helmet. So duplicate the previous footage by Ctrl D and cut the beginning of it so that we can see the rest of the shot. Drag it under the camera and make it a 3D layer. Now copy the transform parameter from the holder layer and paste it onto the video layer. Let's decrease the size and reverse it to make it more like a reflection. Then bring down the opacity and reposition it to get the best crop. Next, copy the holder in the projects panel to make an alpha layer out of it. Copy the holder in the comp this time and replace it with the alpha layer. Choose the alpha layer as the alpha mat. Oh, and we need to increase the background opacity to perform the mask properly. Now we need to play with opacity and colors to match it perfectly with the helmet. So I add the curves and adjust the colors for more contrast. Then set the blending mode to add. But it's too sharp for a reflection, so I will add fast box blur to reduce the sharpness a bit. And also the opacity. Now we have our perfect reflection. Next, we add some sci-fi HUD elements to the helmet, and that is the cool part. So I'll go to the Motion Factory panel, and if you don't have it, you can find and open it from Window under Extensions. You can see that there are many cool sci-fi elements in our Cyberpunk HUD pack. I just need to find the right one for the helmet. I think I like to have some circles, but let me see some more options. The problem I usually have with a pack like this is that there are so many options, and the number of them can work with the scene. That is what makes me choosy about them. Oh, these camera recorders are very close to the shape of the helmet glass. Yes, this one is definitely the one I need there. So double click on it to import and drag it on top of the background layer in the holder comp. The good thing here is that I don't need to track the new layer and make it curvy again, because it follows the rules of the comp automatically. Next, I need some description elements which can be found in Cyberpunk. Maybe some numbers, or perhaps the lower thirds. Right. Item number 7 fits the bill. Again, double click to import to the project panel and drag it to the holder comp. Also reposition and scale as usual. Now to change the colors, we can use the own Motion Factory settings panel to change them all easily. We can also use the same settings inside the comp by pressing F3. Now let's add our final element to the right side of the recorder. I guess line callouts can be cool for that. 12B is the one, so let's import and place it as well. And mask out the area that is off the recorder by an ellipse mask. Let's see what we have. Nice. Now we need to change the text according to the scene. I can have a footage in this little player here, so I'm going to use the same shot we used for the reflection. Copy the footage and bring it to the footage holder of the lower third. And scale and position it as usual. Now let's continue changing the text inside the elements. I think we need to match the colors of the elements to the colors in the scene. So I'll go to the settings and lock the panel to be able to pick the colors from the scene. In situations like this, it's always very helpful to pick the exact colors from the scene instead of just guessing what color to use. It helps everything to blend seamlessly and saves you some time. Now that the colors are matched, let's reduce the opacity of the holder comp a bit. And set the blending mode to add. Let's blur it as well. Oh, this line here tells me that I've forgotten to set the quality of the Bezier warp to 10. Fixed. Always set the quality to 10. Now, onto the blurriness amount. Let's also duplicate the holder to create a glass effect on it. Bring the second one to the front by changing the Z-axis and reduce the opacity a lot. That's our glass effect. I'll duplicate the holder one more time and place it on top of all layers to create a light for the main holder. Scale and position it based on our angle, and increase the blurriness until it looks like a light. Let's have our last preview of this part. Perfect. Now let's move to the last shot where we add our cinematic title. I'll open the movie title comp from the project panel to choose from them. You can see that we have titles for different kinds of films in this pack. I'm looking for something modern for my scene. Right, this one will do. So I'll drag it to the comp on top of the layers. Now let's change the duration of the title based on the footage. And change the title to something sci-fi and cool. Andromeda. Nice. I'll fade out the movie title to add another one for the release date. So I keyframe the in and out of the opacity and ease them by selecting both and pressing F9 to apply ease and ease. Now let's copy the title from the movie title comp and bring it to the main comp. This way I have the same title and effect without the rest of the comp. Then I'll type the release date and align it to the center. And lastly, copy the opacity keyframes from the main title and paste it for this one. And this is it. Let's see what we've done. Interesting. This was an example of how we can create a sci-fi cinematic scene that looks like a short trailer of a film by using some beautiful shots and a couple of cool elements from several PixFlow cinematic packs. You can find the links to all of these packs in the description below if you want to get your hands on them and create your own cinematic stuff. Good luck! And also tell us what you've made in the comment sections, perhaps.